That's what I keep saying, that African Americans need to hear what I'm preaching and stop singing about pain and tragedy and all of that and start singing about him. Hallelujah. Let him father us. Let him elevate us and bring us to a realm. Hallelujah. The mind cannot go, but the glory goes. Hallelujah. Because I live. Think about the power of what I'm telling you. All the fears that people are walking around with. If you connect with the realm, because I live. What transformation will take place? What boldness will take place? That what is moving you, motivating you, is because you see Jesus. And you know he's alive. And he's telling you, because I'm alive, you are alive. You will live. You will live. How can you be defeated, Keenan? You will live. What are you looking at? I remember that commercial years ago. These ugly things. What are you looking at? He said, because I live, you see me. You see me. What do you see? That's why I told you, the first step is ask God to transform your encounter with your Bible. So they stop reading like stories to you and start reading like Jesus to you. That's where you begin to see him, based on what he said, based on what he has done. Because if these things are not taught you and preached to you and hammered into you, you see that you have the Holy Ghost talking in tongues, but life is just plundering you. And you don't understand what it is. And when I'm talking to people, they say, well, I'm praying. I say, you've been praying for how many years? Haven't you seen you are taught to make decrees? You pray and prophesy. You are not begging. Can you imagine if you saw Jesus alive? He said, because I'm alive, you will live. Then what would you be fearing? What would you be fearing? I'm asking you, what would you be fearing if you are looking around at him? Hey, let me find that scripture. It just dropped. It didn't drop when I was studying, but it just dropped. Come on, those of you that have iPad, find it for me. David said, I have set the Lord always before me. I don't know if it's Psalm 16. Is that Psalm 16? I was hearing Psalm 16, but... Psalm 16, 8. Look at, that's why I told you that David was ahead of his time. He wasn't no Old Testament man. Look at what he said. I have set the Lord. Jesus hadn't even died. He said, nobody did this for me. You see what focus does? He said, I set the Lord. What's that word there? Always. In other words, I won't let anything break my focus off of him. I've set the Lord always before me, because he is at my right hand, I shall not be moved. Hallelujah. Therefore, my heart is glad and my glory rejoices. My flesh also shall rest in hope. And he went into the prophetic, talking about Jesus. For thou will not leave my soul in hell, neither will thou suffer thy Holy One to see corruption. Thou will show me the path of life. In thy presence is fullness of joy. At thy right hand, there are. Of course, you know why. Who is at the right hand? Jesus. Glory to God. Okay, now. Come back. He says, let me leave this bullet. Look at the book of Hebrews. Hebrews chapter 2. I want to show you something. God showed me this years ago. And he came back to me today. Hebrews chapter 2, verse 5. For unto the angels had he not put in subjection the world to come. You notice, even the plans for the next world is already finished. And you're talking about your bills. He says that the world to come, that he did not put angels over it. That means both the world and who will run it and all these things have been decided. Isn't that what Jesus told James and John's mama? He said, Lord, grant that my two of my sons. Hey, you said people, eh? So there are only two sides, the right and the left. You didn't even say, okay, let's take one and leave. No, we want both. And then two, whatever, with the rest of you. Jesus said, you don't know what you're asking for. He said, are you able to drink of the cup that I'll drink and, you know, pay the price I'll pay? They said, oh, of course. Okay, you will. They went and got themselves in trouble. But watch now, what did he say? But to sit on my right hand and on my left, he said, it's not mine to give. The Father already prepared those who will sit there. Can you believe that? Is it not the same thing? The next world is all planned out. Who will run it? Who will sit on the right hand of Jesus? You see what broken focus does for you? They keep shifting your focus. So then when you try to walk by faith, there's nothing there. And little problems become major. And then you start running up and down and calling this prayer line and the other prayer line and all this. Hey, who told you that? They didn't have telephones when they handed us this faith. It used to be that a man would get on their face and cry out to God, and the heavens will open up. This one, before the man even prays, he starts calling. Pray with me. Have you prayed yourself? It's a generation of beggars. Daddy Hagin said, in the early days, when there was no telephone, they only had railroad. They would get specific revelation. God would give them an address. They hop on the train. They go to that address and answer the prayer. Wow. Somebody's sick somewhere or something is happening. God gives them direct download. You notice, the more we have, the less glory we walk in. I saw one little, I don't know, it was 7 or 9 year old. And they just keep asking her all these questions, and she's spitting out the scriptures. And here, you have, let me say it like some people, you have concordance. You have concordance. You have all kinds of search engines. You have electronic. You have written. You have everywhere on your phone. But you don't know what's in it. Now watch. For unto the angels had he not put in subjection the world to come, whereof we speak. But one in a certain place testifies, saying, what is man that thou art mindful of him? Or son of man, that thou visitest him. Please listen carefully. Thou madest him a little lower than the angel. He said, we are just made a tad lower in the realm. A tad. So what is missing from us? The glory. Amen. That's why the more glory you retain, then your life becomes naturally supernatural. Amen. So we are made just a little lower than the angels. Just a little. But then you can see all the limitations we operate in for lack of glory. I had not seen, nor ear heard, neither have entered the heart of man the things that God not promised, what he has prepared. It's prepared. It's already ready. Amen. Hallelujah. Waiting on me, hallelujah, to ascend, waiting on me to hunger for it, waiting on me to pursue it. Watch. Thou madest me a little lower than the angels. Thou crownest him with. You notice? He said he crowns man with glory and honor. That means whenever you start paying him attention, focus on him, start seeking him, they bring back what sin and the enemy took out. Yeah. They put the crown back on you. Yeah. And when angels see you, they know a king is coming. Yeah. When demons see you, they know a king is coming. Yeah. The crown is the glory and the honor. Hallelujah. Yeah. What's on your head tonight? You see, you're in a glory house. You saw, when I saw the three guys following me, I said, man, you guys look like angels to me. You remember that Sunday? Yeah. And by the time I got close to them, they were all on the floor. I said, now pick up Brother James. He was so out of it, we couldn't get his head up. Watch. And God said, now, put a seal in his forehead. He said, there are gates open in his life. That's why after you minister to him, they re-enter. He said, now seal him. So when angels see him, they will see the mark you just put on him. Where do you hear such things? Who even understands what I'm talking about? That's the rain the glory brings you in. When they put that crown, it starts fathering you. It starts putting thoughts in your head. It starts giving you revelation. You can't read it in a book. It's original. Hallelujah. You see? You see, he said that the foundation of God standeth sure, and he has a seal. You don't know there's a seal in your forehead. Angels are not God. They're looking for the seal. That's how they know who is who. If you belong to God, if you're a son of God, they see that stamp on your forehead, and they know to accompany you. Hallelujah. And they will have no reason to back away. If you keep the word of God in your mouth and decree what God said, angels fly swiftly and produce miracles. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Watch. I'm walking on. Watch. Watch. Look at this. He says, thou madest him a little lower than the angels. Thou crownest him with glory and honor. And this set him over. Watch, you see, this is what I've been telling you that believers don't understand. He said that he set the man over the works of his hands. God has never designed for you to do. God has always designed for you to manage what he's doing. That's what's wearing people out. Watch. I'm about to show you something. It's so powerful. I pray that it will do for you or give you an eternal change.
Amen.
Are you ready?
Amen.
You need to shout like it. I said, are you ready?
Yes.
Now look at this. Thou madest him a little lower than the angels. Thou crownest him with glory and honor. And this set him over the works of thy hands. Are you ready? Look at verse 8. Thou hast put all things in subjection under his feet. Watch. For in that he put all in subjection under him, he left nothing. Did anybody hear what I'm reading? He said that God has put everything under my feet and your feet. Watch. He said that when he did it, he didn't leave anything that's not under my feet. Your faith hasn't reached it yet. I'll tell you again. I haven't shown you the punchline. He says that he has put everything, all things, underneath our feet. And he said that when he did it, he left nothing. before I get to the punchline. You watch. Have you ever encountered anything that you thought that God has put this under my feet? That's what I'm telling you. He said, I had not seen, nor ear heard. These things are prepared. We are not even there. He said that everything has been put. Well, who knows that? Who thinks that? Who walks in that? Remember now, I haven't shown you the punchline. I'm timing it exactly 9 o'clock, then I'll tell you. Come on, watch. It gets better. Watch. He says, I read verse 8 again. Thou hast put all things in subjection under his feet. For in that he put all in subjection under him, he left nothing that is not. It's either God is telling us the truth or we're saying he's lying. Or we discover that we need to change our focus. Watch now. I keep telling you, I haven't shown you the punchline. He says, but now, hey Lord, we see not yet. Oh Lord. Are you ready? He said that God has put all things under my feet and under your feet. But look at it. He says, but when you look around, you don't see that. Everything looks like nothing is under your feet. Oh, I'm about ready to give it to you. He says, everything has been put under your feet. But when you look around, nothing looks like it. Why is that? We are all looking at the wrong direction. But he said, when I look around, I don't see that. But he said, but we see Jesus. Hey. I don't even believe that your shout could be that tepid. What is he telling you? Everything looks like God has done nothing. Why? So it's only when you look at Jesus. The supernatural downloads begin to occur. And you regain your glory status. He said, but we see Jesus. If you look at the way things are, you're going down. But if you look at him, you begin to discover that everything has been put. That's the biggest mystery of the night. I told you it's a broken focus. That's what's killing us. So you are looking at things, what you're calling a mountain, God says under your feet. It's not a fake profession. He said, I put it there. Then how did God put it there? And it's coming from there to be oppressing me. Because I'm looking at the wrong man. I'm looking at the wrong thing. He said, but we see
Jesus.
When I focus on him, hallelujah, the mountains crumble. The giants fall. They get back where they belong. Underneath my feet, hallelujah. Now, everything has has been put. Isn't it amazing? I told you I'll tell you that at 9, and I did. He said, everything has been put under your feet. He said, but when you look around, you don't see that. But when you get your eyes on him, that's why he told you, looking unto Jesus, the author. So, you're going to get your focus back. Remember now, I say it again. He didn't tell you that this is what your faith is going to accomplish. He said he had already done it. He has put all things. So your decision tonight is whether you are going to quit being impressed by what does not look like it. Satan's yellow press. And get your eyes back on Jesus. The author, and let him start downloading to you, prophesying to you, fathering you, mothering you, because he says, I'm not going to leave you orphans. I will come to you. Beloved, did you hear that thunder from the throne? Do you receive the word of faith that will change everything? My water was stirred. Listening to that word, all things have been put under my feet. Doesn't matter what it looks like. He said he has done it. I kept repeating in the message, this is not something your faith is going out to go and obtain. He said it's something that's already done. But when you look around, he may not look like it. That's why they told us not to look at any of these things. Think about it, that the Lord Jesus was there. He showed up walking on the storm that was trying to bury the disciples. And Peter said, then if it's you, bid me come. And Peter walked on water. But the moment he shifted from Jesus, whoop, he sank. He got impressed by the wind and the waves and the storm. So when you look, you don't see all things put under your feet, but we see Jesus. Hey, when we look at him, the mountain crumbles, the valleys are exalted, the crooked paths are made straight, the rough places are made smooth. Satan can't win when our focus is on him. When our focus is on him. The God that win for you on the outside will win for you on the inside. Receive this word today. Jesus said, because you see me, because I live, you shall live. What are you looking at? What's your focus on? Get it back on the Lord Jesus. And victory is guaranteed and assured for 2022. You shall not die till you see the kingdom come with power, till you see the Son of Man come in his kingdom, till you see the glory revealed. Same thing he said to Simeon. Same thing saying to you in this age of pandemic and all the variants of COVID and all this stuff. Overseas people are dealing with insecurity, rash murders and all kinds of craziness. Fear everywhere. Fear everywhere. And yet he says, fear not. Fear not. Every day fear not. I haven't counted it. They said there are 365 of them in the scriptures. That's one for every day. One for every day. We see Jesus. We see Jesus. That's why I said in one of the messages, see, it doesn't matter what Satan is telling me. I'm just listening for what he's saying because the counsel of the Lord shall stand. And until you've been tested and shoved and shaken, and you stay in faith, and God comes and vindicates you, and you win, you will never enter the realm of this certainty I'm describing. You know that faith will work. You know that you will prevail. You know. That's what David said to Goliath. He said, the God that delivered me from the lion and the bear, he will put you in my hand.
You don't go out there facing the giant when you haven't won in the backsides of the wilderness. Allow God to take you to victory. Stop running from difficulties. Hear what he's saying. Act on it and win it. And then when you get out there, you will not be shaken at all. You will hear the thoughts of doubt, but baby, please, please, get out of here. In Jesus' name, glory to God. You brag on God. You brag on his faithfulness. You brag on his power. You brag on his love. The God of your covenant will never fail. It's impossible for God to lie. Amen. And don't you ever judge God based on another believer's experience. Because this happened to them doesn't mean it will happen to you. No. You're entitled to your own experiences with God. I am self-contained in my God. I'm not looking. When I see people doing better and greater things, I thank God for them. I say, well, I'm going to continue to follow God personally. I can't covet what they have. I can't rush in. No, I can't get all that. I miss my blessing. No, I'm blessed where I am. Everything comes to me in the presence of God. Learn it. Receive it. Allow us to disciple you. You'll make it into eternal life and you'll win on this earth. Here and hereafter. That's a guarantee. That's a guarantee. Jesus. Love you. God sent us to you. Stop wasting time. Stop delaying. Get on board. You will not remain the same. We love you. Bye-bye. When dead things come.